Start. So I welcome you all for today's session. Today we'll see experiments related to strength of materials. So first we'll take a look on list of the experiments. For SOM, that is strength of materials, total we have 10 experiments, namely tension test on mild and TMT steel, then shear test on mild steel, torsion test on mild steel, impact test on metals, compression test, bending test, water absorption and efflorescence on bricks, compressive strength on bricks, then flexural strength of flooring tiles and abrasion test of flooring tiles. So if you observe, under these 10 experiments, we have 4 materials, that is steel, timber, bricks and tiles. Because as we are in civil engineering, if you observe, steel bars are used in the construction of slab, beam, column and foundation. Secondly, timber is used, that is wood is used for doors and windows. Then similarly, bricks are used for constructing walls and last, the tiles. You place the tiles as a flooring or in the bathroom as dado, etc. So these 10 experiments are focused on studying the properties, various properties as per the experiments you can observe from the title for these 4 materials. So now, most important thing is oral exam is based on these 10 experiments and it carries 50 marks. Yesterday we already seen that theory carries 100 marks and oral examination is based on your term work, means on these 10 experiments, and these 10 experiments are based on your theory syllabus. That is 6 units and these 10 experiments contribute to this 50 marks. So for this 50 marks, you must be having a simple question. Can we score good marks in SOM? Because we have 6 units and 10 experiments. Is it possible to score good marks? Well, the answer is yes, you can do it. But how to do that? Let us see. So for that case, we have the solution. We identified 3 steps or some 3 points on which if you focus on these 3 points, it will be easier for you to score good marks. That is, first, by understanding the title of the experiment, then basics behind that experiment, and then its procedure. We'll see it step by step. So let's begin. Let's start. So experiment number 1. Today we'll see this experiment number 1, that is tension test on mild steel and TMT steel. So as you already mentioned, what we need is step 1, that is understand the title of the experiment. Now what's the title? The title is tension test on mild steel and TMT steel. So if we split it, we get 3 questions. There is tension test, mild steel and TMT steel. Let's see. So point number 1, what is tension test? What is tension? In tension test, a tensile force is applied on a member or material. And you already studied in trusses, analysis of truss in engineering mechanics. Some members are tensile members, some members are compressive members. So what is tensile force? When a force is applied or acting away from the body, these terms are tensile force, and if it is acting towards the body, it becomes a compressive force. So as it is tension test, so a force will be applied on the material or member away from the body. So this is the point number 1. Second, what is mild steel? So in our construction, instead of plates or other sections, we use steel bars. So what is mild steel? Let's say you might have seen these plain type of bars. So it has some properties, that is, it's a plain bar. Secondly, it has low tensile strength. That is Fe 250 grade. This Fe stands for iron, and 250 is its tensile strength. That is 250 is 250 Newton per mm square is the tensile strength of my steel bar. Therefore, for grading point of view, it is denoted by Fe 250. And last one is, it is ductile in nature. You must be knowing. Third point, what is TMT steel or TMT bar? So similar to plain bar, you must have seen these kind of bars. These bars have some designs or some threads or some textures. So these design, threads or texture is called as So these textures or design or threads are termed as rogations. So these bars are also Hello, am I audible to everyone? Okay, so TMT bar has high tensile strength, that is Fe 415, Fe 500 grade. Means these bar are having tensile strength of 415 Newton per mm square and 500 Newton per mm square. And last one is, it is brittle in nature as compared to my steel bar. Now moving to second step, the basics of the experiments. The basic is tension test. So what is tension test? That we already seen. So tension test is carried out on steel bars to find the tensile strength of the material. As we are dealing with strength of material subject, means our target is strength. So as per this test, this tension test, we will be carrying out or we will be calculating the tensile strength of the material, that is steel bars, mild steel bar and TMT steel bar. So tensile strength is given by load upon cross sectional area, and its unit is Newton per mm square. And you are already aware of the meaning of strength, that is capacity of resistance. Now third part or third step, that is the procedure of the experiment. Now this is a universal testing machine. It is also called as UTM, abbreviated as UTM. It has basically two components or two parts. The left part is called as loading unit, and right part is called as control unit. The specimen is to be placed on left hand side in the upper region as well as in lower region, and it is operated by right hand side. Whereas on the left hand side, on loading unit, we have three component, basic components. That is upper crosshead, middle crosshead and lower crosshead, based on the test. Why it is called a universal testing machine? Because apart from tension test, you can perform various tests like compression test, flexure test, shear test, bending test. Therefore it is called a universal testing machine. So as far as tension test is concerned, the tension test is carried out in upper zone, which is highlighted in red color. And on right hand side, we have control unit. It has buttons, some software related assembly, and two valves. Left valve is called as pressure release valve, and right valve is called as pressure valve. We can operate the machine through these valves. So moving further, this is the procedure. First, measure the diameter and length of the specimen. Next, mark the initial gauge length on the bar. What is gauge length? It is 5 times of diameter. It is used to measure the extension of the wire. Then place the specimen into universal testing machine. Then fill all the values, required fields, and start the machine. As it starts, it will show some values of load and displacement. And based on these values, that is load and displacement, we need to calculate the tensile strength of the bar, steel bar. And lastly, measure the final diameter and final gauge length of the test piece or specimen and plot the stress strain curve. So this is our typical stress strain curve. You can observe on y-axis we have stress, x-axis we have strain, and this is a stress strain curve for my steel specimen, for my steel bar, where you can observe from zero ordinate to this upper point. This point is called a yield point, because beyond this yield point the material goes into plastic stage, whereas before the yield point it is under elastic zone. Means if you cancel the load, it will regain its original shape and size and will come back to zero. Whereas beyond yield point, it will not regain its original shape and size because it will move into plastic stage. And there is some point where the material or our bar takes maximum load. That is your ultimate load. And the strength, it becomes your ultimate strength. And lastly, it breaks. That point is called as flexure load. So we need to find out or note down the values and thereby draw the stress strain curve, which is very similar to load deflection curve. Now we have studied the title, the basics, the procedure. Now the question is how to visualize the experiment online. So for that case, let's see the virtual experiment. So this is our website of virtual labs operated by NIT and IITs. So you can observe the schematic diagram of universal testing machine, where you can observe the left hand side, the loading unit, and right hand side we have control unit. Lower crosshead, middle crosshead, and upper crosshead. And along with that, we need dial gauges also. So step one, measure the diameter of the bar by using vernier caliper. After measuring, measure its length of the specimen, then mark the gauge length, on the bar. You can observe the gauge length is marked on the bar. Then coming to our UTM, lower the middle crosshead, then place the specimen in UTM and fix the bar. Then attach the dial gauges, which will measure the extension between the marked gauge length. So reset the dial gauges to zero. Then we start the machine. When it starts, it will note down some readings, and you can observe here the fracture of the specimen. When its capacity is over, it breaks. Then switch off the machine and plot the graph. So this is a typical stress strain curve. Then beyond that, again rejoin the two broken pieces, measure its final diameter and final gauge length. It will help us to determine the strain in lateral direction as well as in linear direction. This extension of length and reduction in diameter. And then you can observe some points. So we have another section where you can observe. See, a bar is attached to the universal testing machine, and when the tensile load is applied, it breaks. See how it breaks. As it elongates, the diameter gets reduced, and when its capacity is over, it breaks into two pieces. You can see again. So this way, we can perform the tension test on mild steel and TMT steel to calculate its tensile strength. As you already mentioned, the tensile strength of mild steel bar is 250 Newton per mm square, and that of TMT bar or HYSD bar, that is high yield strength deform bar, it is 415 Newton per mm square and 500 Newton per mm square. So this way, you can perform the experiment number one, that is tension test on metals.